Let us pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Geraldine, whom you have called on February the 1st, 2023, to journey to you. And since she'd hoped and believed in you, grant that she may be led to our new homeland to delight in its everlasting joys. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite Pauline to read our first reading.
A reading from the book of Revelations. I, John, heard a voice from heaven say to me, "Write down, happy are those who die in the Lord." Happy indeed, the Spirit says, now they can rest forever after their work, since their good deeds go with them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters leads me to revive my drooping spirit. He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these you give me comfort.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever.
The Lord is my shepherd.
The second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The life and death of each of us has its influence on others. If we live, we live with the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord, so that alive or dead, we belong to the Lord. This explains why Christ both died and came to life. It was so that he might be Lord both for the dead and for the living. We shall all have to stand before the judgment seat of God. As Scripture says, by my life, it is the Lord who speaks. Every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue will praise God. It is God, therefore, that each of us must go to give an account of oneself. This is the word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I'm going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said, Lord, we don't know where you're going, so how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Fear no more the heat of the sun, nor the furious winter's rages. Thou thy earthly task hast done, home hast gone and tamed thy wages. So writes marvellous dramatist William Shakespeare in his play Cymbeline. I love that phrase, home hast gone, for Geraldine has gone to the ultimate home of all of us, the loving embrace of God, sacramentally prefigured by her marriage to Brian. We come alive when we love someone, don't we? And we come alive when we realize somebody really loves us. How wonderfully alive we will be when we are embraced by that infinite love of our generous God. Geraldine has gone home and tamed her wages. And the quotation from the book of Revelations teaches us a similar truth. Happy are those who die in the Lord. Happy indeed, the Spirit says. Now they can rest forever after their work, since their good deeds go with them. Such deeds were described by the poet William Wordsworth as the best portion of a good person's life, the little, nameless, unremembered acts of love and kindness. How many of these little, nameless, unremembered acts of kindness and love Geraldine quietly and constantly carried out for Brian and the family and for so many others in her nursing career? These good deeds have gone with her to the throne of a very grateful God. I'm a great fan of the English mystic Julian of Norwich, who assures us that God is very grateful to us for all that we do for God and for God's holy people, for family, for friends, for our social contacts. God is holding them to God's heart and is very grateful to Geraldine for doing them day after day. We are sad at the loss, and rightly so. It would be inhuman not to grieve and to embrace our grief. As the poet, the famous Persian mystic Rumi urges us, welcome into our hearts all our feelings. They will be the start of something new. Embrace the grief, but as we do, look up to our loving God, who will support us through this intense sorrow and lead us to acceptance. Keep in mind what the psalm tells us. The Lord is our shepherd. There's nothing I shall want. Geraldine now wants nothing. She has God forever and ever. God has led her to fresh and green pastures. There God has given Geraldine eternal repose. Like every other human being, I am sure Geraldine's spirit drooped from time to time. But now God has led her to restful waters and has revived her drooping spirit for all eternity. God has walked with her all the days of her life, through the bright times and the dark times, and never again will she fear any evil. She can affirm that goodness and kindness have followed her all the days of her life, and now she dwells forever in God's own house. St. Paul reminds us that our life has an influence on others. What an enormous influence on others did Geraldine's life of generous servant, day in and day out, have. We shall all have to stand before the judgment seat of God, but it is the judgment seat of a loving, merciful, generous, and compassionate God, who, as I mentioned before, is so grateful to us for all the good deeds we have performed. When Geraldine gave an account of herself, we all know she had much to present to this generous and gracious God. When John urges us in the Gospel not to let our hearts be troubled, he's not saying, don't grieve. He is saying what St. Paul told us to do. Do not grieve like those who have no hope. Grieve, but grieve with hope. Trust in God and trust in Jesus. Slowly we will come to acceptance. We won't lose the pain, but it will be different. Last year I met a man whose two teenage sons I buried many years ago. There was still a hole in his heart, but he had come to a place of peace. That will happen to us if we keep pouring out our sorrow to Jesus. Through him, Geraldine has come to the Father, and now she has taken the place prepared for her by Jesus, and now is in one of those many mansions in her Father's house. Keep thinking of the psalm, goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. This is now Geraldine's lot, because in the Lord's own house she dwells forever and ever.
Thank you, Father Paul. I just want to add a few memories of mine. Most of these memories go back to when we were all a bit younger and I could run around the block. Geraldine was an attentive and involving person. She listened. I remember quite often we sat around the kitchen table at Brian and Geraldine's house, drinking coffee and solving all the problems of the world. And once we exhausted that, we got onto the church. And Geraldine sat there smoking a cigarette, as she did in those days. And every now and again, she would cut across Brian. And there were usually words of wisdom. Geraldine and Brian received the sacrament of marriage in St. Dominic's Church, Camberwell. If you look at the photo in the funeral booklet of Brian and Geraldine, I've never seen Brian's chest expand so much. He had a bride whom he was truly proud of, and that just didn't cease on their wedding day. Went for 57 years. Geraldine was Brian's friend. More than that, Brian's soulmate. More than that, they gave to each other on a daily basis the sacrament of marriage. When I was a young priest, I was pretty green, but I went out to Brian and Geraldine's quite a bit. They showed me what marriage was, not by talking about it, by doing it. They showed me what to be a parent was, not by talking about it, but by doing it. Geraldine was a very concerned and loving mother. I know that because on some occasions she would have a bit of a yarn with me about one or other of her children. The love for her children shone through her. And just the way she treated them at home, they had a freedom, and yet they had their boundaries. Geraldine was a loving spouse, a loving parent. Professionally, she was a nurse, and I often saw her as Brian and I were there going off to night shift. Geraldine was a woman of faith, of strong faith, with a strong influence from the Dominicans. She was a frequent attender at the Eucharist and took part with faith. More than that, Geraldine was a missionary. She was a lay missionary. In the days when lay missionaries weren't all that common, she worked with the Redemptorist lay community at Apollo Bay for holidays, where all the kids were too. We all had a great time. And on married weekends for married couples called Genesis Weekends. Geraldine's witness and wisdom was greatly valued in that ministry. Finally, I am sure that the Lord's arms are open to her. Her friend is welcoming her. May she rest in peace.
Please stand, if you're able, to recite the prayers of the faithful. I invite those presenting the prayers to come forward.
Dear Lord, pray for Poppy and give him the strength to live his life with strength and joy. And let Nana rest in peace, that he is with Katrina, Genevieve, Claire and Dream, who are deeply devoted to him and who continue to love and care for him. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, pray for Nana's grandchildren, Jason, Aaron, Madison, Alex, Jessica, Matthew, and great-grandchildren, Chelsea and Winona. Bless their life's journey with the love and happiness that Nana enjoyed. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, pray for Nana's sisters, Joan and Margaret, and daughters, Joanne, Katrina, Genevieve, and Claire. Bless them with the health and happiness. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, pray for Nana's departed sister Frances and her beloved son Alex, who she now joins in the kingdom of heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, pray for all the medical professionals who cared for Nana and all the nurses who go after her and continue to care for our loved ones in their time of need. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Father, these prayers and the prayers in our hearts we present to you through your gift to us, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated now as we bring forward our offertory gifts for the celebration at the Lord's table, a foretaste for us of the heavenly banquet to which Geraldine is now going.
Thank you.
Let us pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Lord, accept the gifts we offer, and grant that our sister Geraldine may be taken up into the glory with your Son, in which great mystery of love we are all united. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end, we acclaim. Holy indeed, the fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Peter our Bishop, and all the clergy. And remember your servant Geraldine, whom you've called from this world to yourself.
Grant that she, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, let us now pray.
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's show to one another a sign of the peace of Christ. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Geraldine may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her when, again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Geraldine, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she too will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn to us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of our faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister Geraldine forever. Amen.
Amen.
In peace now, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Be not afraid, I am God. Take one arm at a time, because I'll need one arm to hang on.
Thank you.
turn this